So good afternoon students, let's begin our today's class with the same chapter, periodic classification of the elements, and we were on the topic modern periodic table. Okay, so yesterday we have discussed that Henry was the chemist. He arranged the periodic table in a new way according to his periodic law. And what was his periodic law? What was his base of the periodic arrangement? Can you tell me on the basis of which property or which thing the Henry prepare his periodic table?
Atomic number.
Yes, atomic number. He clearly stated that the chemical and physical properties of the element are the periodic function of their atomic number. That is why he arranged all the elements which were present according to the increasing atomic number, as you can see. Okay, so he divided his periodic table into four blocks. This hydrogen and lithium block is S block. This boron to helium block is P block. And this scandium to like titanium, this is D block. And that lanthanoid and actinoid, after several experiments, they just gave a special place to the lanthanoid and actinoid, means radioactive elements, a special place in the periodic table, and that is F. Okay, so this thing I have already told you that he just divide his periodic table and named it under periods and group. The vertical arrangement is known as
groups,
and the horizontal one known as
periods.
So this is the basic property of this periodic table, that the entire family have the similar property to the head one. For example, I think you remember that octet rule, na? He arranged all the elements according to their physical and chemical properties. Means if Sa is following, hydrogen is following, has some specific property, then lithium will also show those properties. Okay, Sa, Re, Gamma, Pa, Dha, Ni, Sa. After that seven, he put that eight element below the Sa. So that was the octet rule. ठीक है, इट्स लाइक अ म्यूजिकल नोट. सो उसी चीज को अगर हम यहाँ लाते हैं, तो उन्होंने भी यही कहा कि भाई ही प्लेस द एलिमेंट्स इन द सेम वे एज मींस दैट द प्रॉपर्टी व्हिच द हेड एलिमेंट इज हैविंग, द रेस्ट ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स विल आल्सो शोज द सेम प्रॉपर्टी. फॉर एग्जांपल, हाइड्रोजन लिथियम इज देयर, लिथियम इज मेटल. And the metals which are below, the elements which are below this lithium will also show the same property. For example, if we consider the electronic film, so what is the atomic number of lithium? Yes, what is the atomic number of lithium?
Three.
Electronic configuration. Electronic configuration in sub atomic orbitals. Yes.
1s2, 2s1.
Yes.
1s2s.
Outermost shell is S. That is 2. Let's just come to this sodium. Atomic number is 11. And the shell which participate will be 3s. Okay. So
yes,
outermost, one. Yes. The outermost shell will be S and the valency electron will be 1. Means all the elements will show the same property as like the head. So the elements which are in the starting of the group are considered to be the head of the family. For example, if we relate this thing to our family, hum ye kehte hain ki bhai hamare dadaji se hamare father aaye, father se hum aaye, and next this progeny will go on. So we have some characteristics, means your father like gain some characteristics from your grandfather. You gain characteristics from your father, and this will go on. So if someone asks you that what is the progeny, तो आप क्या बोलोगे? हमारे मतलब अभी तो सिर्फ डैड के नाम से जाने जाते हैं, लेकिन अगर आप विलेज एरिया में, अगर आप डीएनए पढ़ाए ना बायो में, कि डीएनए विल इनहेरिट, मींस इज इट अ इनहेरिटेडिटी व्हीकल, ये ट्रांसफर जेनेटिकली इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम वन जनरेशन टू अनदर जनरेशन, मींस दे आर लिंक्ड. अगर आपका डीएनए और आपके दादाजी का डीएनए मिला जाए, तो इट विल बी लाइक सेम, because you belong to the same progeny, you will show the things which is related to your grandfather. So same with this, these are the head of the family, means the other elements which are below this, they will shows the same physical and chemical properties, as well as the outermost participating shell will be same, and the electrons which are present in the outermost shell will be equal, means valency electron will be equal in all them. Okay, so let's just go down. This thing I think we have done already, this group part we have done yesterday. Okay, so group part, groups are the vertical lines in which elements are arranged. Okay, so we have a proper sequence of the arrangement in this periodic table, and the specific name is associated to these elements. This first hydrogen family is known as alkali metals. This first 11, the elements which come in the first group are alkali metals. The beryllium family, you can note it down somewhere, take a pen and paper with you and note it down. This beryllium family is alkali earth metals. Okay, so in this periodic table he gave the specific name to that family. For example, people used to give this Sharma family, Gupta family, that will go on continue. So these hydrogen family is what I've told you, hydrogen family is alkali metals.
Alkali family.
Perfect. Beryllium family is alkali earth metals.
Alkali.
Perfect. And he gave helium family a special name, that is noble gases or
noble gas family.
Perfect. Fluorine family is halogen family.
Halogen.
Yes, halogens. Fluorines are halogens. So at that time he just gave specific numbers, specific name to these families. Okay. After that, when he keep on like experimenting on these elements, and he was trying to find out how they are behaving, what are the specific properties of these elements, so he was concluded that the way he is arranging the periodic table is in a systematic way, means all the elements of a single family follow the same pattern. For example, in the lithium family, they have 1111 electron in the outermost shell. Fluorine family have 7-7 electrons in the outermost shell, right? So at that time, the main points of his periodic table was that the element present in the first group, first and second group on the left side, and 13 to 17 group on the right side of the periodic table are called normal elements. That is why he gave specific names to these, because we have pure elements here. Means in helium family, we have all the inert gases, right? In helium family, we have all the noble gases, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. So we have, means outermost shell is completely filled. All the elements shows the same property. And fluorine family halogens, they also shows the same property. Like means we don't have any mixing in these elements. They are pure elements. They purely behave like inert gases. Fluorine family will behave like non-metals. Hydrogen family will behave like metal. And beryllium family, which is known as alkali earth metals, will behave like also metals. But in D block and all those elements before this group, eighth group, the element shows mixed property. We have metals here, we have non-metals here, we have metalloids in this group. Okay, so that is why he, in the beginning of the explanation of the periodic table, he just took these two groups, first and this fourth, and last one is these helium family and fluorine family. Okay, why? Because they are pure elements. They purely shows the property as they are. If metal family is there, all the elements in that behave like metals. If non-metals are there, they will behave like non-metals. Okay. So these elements are known as normal elements or the representative elements. Representative means specific head elements. They are, means fluorine family is representing the non-metals. Hydrogen lithium family is representing the metals. And helium is representing it, the noble gases. So these are the representators of their family. Okay. So their outermost shell are incomplete. They are also called typical and main group elements. But the elements which are a part of this helium family have the incomplete outermost shell. So these are known as the typical families or the main group elements. Let's just go to the second point, which was given by Henry, was element present in 3rd to 12th in the middle of the periodic table are called transition element. This thing I've already told you, the third, started from the scandium to the 12th group, all those elements are known as transition elements. Although 11 and 12 elements are strictly speaking not transition element, but there is a group 11 and 12. 11 and 12, in that we have mixed species of elements. For example, in 11 and 12 group, we have metalloids along with the non-metals, and we have one or two metals with it. Okay, in P block, we have a mixture. Okay, we have metals there, we have metalloids there, and we have some sort of non-metals there, right? So in 11th and 12th group, we can't speak a transition element because we have mixed species. In 12th group and 11th group, we have metalloid with metals and non-metals. Okay, so their two outermost shells are incomplete. Their outermost two shells are incomplete. However, it should be noticed here that more and more electrons are added to valency shell only in case of normal elements. When we do electron filling, right? When we do electron filling means metals donate their electron, non-metals accept their electrons, mean electron filling will be there. That is why the bond is formed between the elements. Okay, so when we do the electron filling, हमारे valency electrons में क्या होते हैं? Outermost shell में valency electrons unpaired state में होते हैं. If you want to fill that, then you have to accept the electron from other element. ठीक है? So this can only happen in the case of normal element. हम ये सिर्फ normal elements के case में ही कर सकते हैं. Okay? But we can't do this thing with helium family because the outermost shell is completely filled. Right? So, in transition elements, the electrons are added to incomplete inner shell. Obviously, in transition elements, the electrons add to the incomplete shell. The electron will fill those shells which are incomplete, where unpaired electrons are present. Okay? Since, because transition elements is D-block elements. D-block elements means, what do you mean by D-block elements? I have specified S block, P block, D block. Why D block elements are considered to be the specific name given to the D block element? Because the outermost participating shell is D. In P block, the outermost participating shell is P. In S block, the outermost shell which take part in electron filling is S. And in F, we have F subshell participating in the electron filling. So in D block, we have to fill how many electrons? What is the, like, how many electrons can be filled in D block? Can you tell me how many electrons we can fill in D block? Yes. Aksham?
10.
10. Akshita, very good. 10. So if we have less number of electrons there, so if we start electron filling, so we require 10 electron to fill that D block. Okay, so it has the maximum number of electron filling capacity. I'm not talking about F has more capacity to fill. Okay, so in D block we require 10 electrons to completely fill the octet, the outermost shell. So that is why these things, the electron filling can go smoothly in the transition element. So elements 113, 115 and 117 are not known but included at their expect position. These three elements are the higher elements. We are talking about the lanthanoids and actinoids, right? So lanthanoids, these comes under lanthanoids and actinoids. But there is a special property about these elements that they show properties sometimes similar to the metals, sometimes similar to the non-metals. That is why their position was actually not fixed even in this table. Okay, he was confused that where I can put this thing, because naturally they are radioactive elements. Sometimes when we do chemical reaction, they can behave like metals. And when we require a reaction and we can put it in it, so they at that time they behave like non-metals. So their position was like indefinite. Okay. Group 18 on extreme right. Extreme right means that helium family. Extreme right of the periodic table contains the noble gas. Their outermost shell contains 8 electrons. I have already told you. What is the atomic number of argon? Tell me fast. What is
18.
18. Okay. Outermost shell which they participate in the like valency shell. What is the valency shell? Outermost shell which take part in the electron pulling. Tell me the electronic configuration, beta. What is the electronic configuration of argon? First, fast. Yes. Who can tell me electronic configuration of argon? This is your homework to revise all the elements, the atomic number and the electronic distribution in the shells. Because if you don't learn this thing, you will not be able to do anything in with the periodic table. Okay, so this is your homework. You have to learn first 20 elements along with their electronic distribution in subshells. Okay, so let's just come to the inner transition elements. Inner transition elements are 14 elements with
atoms. 2, 3, 6.
What?
3s2, 3p6.
Perfect. P, outermost shell which participating is P. And we can fill 6 electron, means outermost shell is completely filled in argon. So that is why the helium family is considered to be as in noble family, noble gas family or inert gases, because they don't react with anything. Anything which react, any element which react, it means it has excess of electrons, means unpaired of electrons are present there. That is why that element need to donate or accept the electron. But in case of noble gases, the, all the electrons are paired. Outermost shell is completely filled. So they need not to react with anything. They are stable, right? So let's just come to the inner transition elements. The 14 elements with atomic mass 58 to 71 are called the lanthanoids. We were talking about the lanthanoids in the beginning of the class. So what are lanthanoids? The element which are between 58 to 71 are lanthanoids. They are placed along with the elements lanthanum, atomic number 57. This lanthanoid series start after 57. Lanthanum ke baad ye series start hoti hai. Aur in series ko periodic table mein specifically mention nahi kiya ja sakta. So that is why they just zoom it out and put it below the periodic table. आपने देखा होगा ना periodic table के नीचे एक strip होती है, two line strip, जिसमें columns and periods are there. So in one period they arrange the lanthanoids, in second period they arrange the actinoids. Okay. Okay. Because of very close resemblance to them. Okay. For convenience sake, they choose. They are shown separately below the main periodic table for convenience, so that we can find out where the F block is present, because the center part of the periodic table is known as D block, left part is S block, right part is P block. So just to make the thing simpler, they just put it below the periodic table so that we can find out these are F block elements, lanthanoids and actinoids. So let's just come to actinoids. 14 elements are there in the actinoid family, 19 to 103. Okay, these are known as actinoids. They are placed along with the elements actinine. After actinine they are placed, which the atomic number is 89. So after this, actinoid family start with actinine, lanthanide family start with lanthanum. Okay, so it go up to 103, and it's same position because of very resemblance with them. They are separately below, they are placed separately below the main periodic table along with the lanthanoid. Okay, so let's just, we have done with the groups. I think group part is clear to you all, beta. You are familiar where are the metals placed, where are the non-metals placed, and the center part is metal, non-metal and metalloids. Okay, when we go to the periodic table, I will tell you how to learn the periodic table. This thing will be more clear to you then. Okay, so let's just go to the periods. What are the periods? Periods are like they are arranged the horizontal row. This is, for example, if we assume this thing as periodic table, so these are vertical groups, vertical lines are groups, and these horizontal are known as periods. So the the period number is also the number of shells which start filling up in it. For example, in element of third period. Third period means, can you tell me what is the third period? First period is hydrogen family. Second period is lithium period. And third is, name the element which comes below the lithium.
Sodium.
Yes, sodium. Perfect, sodium. So the third period, which is sodium, start filling the shells from right to the first elements of the sodium is 281, means last electron is 1, has 1 electron in its valency shell. Okay, while the last element of this period has the completely filled shell, that is 8 electron, argon is there. So there is a gradually filling of the electron in the shell. Along the group we have the same valency electrons, but along the periods there is a gradual increase in the atomic number. For example, the valency shell in sodium is 1, magnesium is 2, means they are filling the electrons gradually along the period. Okay, but when we go to the group, the valency electrons will be same. Is this clear to you all, beta? Sodium 1, magnesium, when we go to the next group, magnesium is there in this, in the same period, 2, aluminium 3, silicon 4, phosphorus 5, sulfur, chlorine, argon. And at the end of every period, we have inert gas, means electron filling will stop there. Got it? So he just gave some important points about the period. The first period is the shortest period. First period is for shortest because hydrogen and helium, only two elements are there in this family. The third and the second and the third are the short period. These are the short period because they have eight elements. Okay, six in that part, six in boron, like P block, and one is the two are lithium and the next beryllium. So that is eight. Fourth and fifth period are the long period because it has 18. But six and seven period are very long because it contains 32 elements. Right. 32 elements, and along with that, there are so many radioactive elements, lanthanoids and actinoids are also included in that. So he just explained about a short things regarding the periods. So these periods will be clear to you all, beta. You have any doubt in periods and group? Yes, period and group concept is clear to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what are the merits of modern periodic table over the Mendeleev periodic table? Because he improvised the Mendeleev periodic table, right? So what was the merit over his periodic table? First, position of isotopes. All the isotopes of same elements have different atomic masses, as we know this thing very well. Isotopes are where atomic number is same, but atomic mass is different, but same atomic number. So therefore, they occur the same position in the modern periodic table. So there is no need to give special position to the isotope. But Mendeleev gives the special position to all the isotopes of the elements because he considers the atomic mass as the base of his periodic table. उन्होंने atomic mass को सिर्फ base लिया. तो इसलिए उन्होंने अपनी periodic table में क्या किया बेटा? उन्होंने अलग-अलग different positions उनको दिया periodic table में. But in modern periodic table, the base was atomic number. Since all the isotopes have same atomic number, that is why a single position has been given to that element in the periodic table, right? Because so what was his concept? Because all of them are chemically same. Because all these isotopes are chemically same. For example, hydrogen. We have three isotopes of hydrogen. What are those? What are the three isotopes of hydrogen? Can you tell me?
Protium, deuterium, and tritium.
Okay. Protium, deuterium, and tritium. Three isotopes of carbon are these three. But we have only one hydrogen in our periodic table because the atomic number is same. Chemical properties are same. Physical property is same. So there is no need to give a specific position to the isotope in the periodic table. So, second, anomalous pair of the elements. when elements are arranged in this periodic table according to the atomic number, the anomaly regarding to the certain pair of elements in the Mendeleev periodic table appears. For example, atomic number of argon and potassium is 18 and 19 respectively. Argon is 18 and 19 is potassium. So therefore, argon with similar atomic number comes before the potassium. Although its atomic mass is greater and the property of both the elements matches with the elements respective to their group. So there is a conflict on the position of potassium and argon in the Mendeleev periodic table, right? ये conflict था कि भाई potassium और argon को हम किस तरीके से रखें, because 18 atomic number इसका है और 19 इसका है. But they shows the properties when we arrange these two elements according to the atomic number, they shows the properties according to that group in which they are placed. Argon shows the noble gas property, that is why argon is in the helium family, and potassium shows metallic property. This is highly reactive, which resembles to the sodium. So that is why potassium plays in that metallic portion, the lithium hydrogen family. Got it? So that was the conflict which was resolved by the Henry in modern periodic table. The position of argon and potassium was specified, that argon will be placed in the noble gases and potassium plays under the below this sodium in hydrogen. Okay. So I think we have done with this today's topic. Tomorrow we will do the X-ray experiment which was performed by the Henry before, he was predicting the modern periodic table. Okay. We'll continue this chapter with the same topic and periodic properties. Your homework is to read about groups and period very well, so that you will be familiar about all the families which are present in the periodic table. Okay, all the groups which have same properties. Mainly you have to learn about the head of the family. Okay, you have to learn about the head of the family. If you are familiar with the head of the family, then rest of the property will be clear to you. Okay, so read it well. We'll continue our class tomorrow with the same topic.